Assalamu alaikum dear brothers and sisters, welcome back in action. This is approximations and error. I think this is the second video I'll be uploading, God willing. I hope you have now the basic concept of this chapter. Today we are going to see more complex examples from the chapter for information. Okay, so that in the examination, that is the KCSC, you don't suffer, okay? Without wasting time, let me start with this one. This is our first example, guys. This is our example one. We are told the length and the width of a rectangular paper. The length and width of a rectangular paper. Of a rectangular paper measured to the nearest centimeters. Measured to the nearest centimeters. Measured to the nearest centimeters. Are found to be 18 centimeter and 12 centimeter respectively, okay? Full stop. So you are told find the percentage error in this perimeter. Find the percentage error in it is perimeter, okay? Full stop. Don't forget that this is the rectangle for your information. When you sketch, this is the rectangle. So we have 18 centimeter by 18 centimeter by 12 centimeter. So what you're gonna do is in the examination, what you're gonna do is you take the length. Come here, length. Remember here, both the dimensions are in whole number, and we say that the least unit of any measurement, which is a whole number, is what? Is one, unless or otherwise stated, okay? Now, we know that the least unit in this measurement, the length 18, is one, okay? So the absolute error will obviously be 0.5, that is half times one. So let me get the least absolute error. I'm going to say absolute error is equal to a half times least unit. This time I'm sure you are very much familiar with this thing because we had the first video, okay? So in this situation, absolute error in both dimensions will be, absolute error will be a half times one, which is 0.5. So for the length now, length, we have our length at 18. Then right here on top of this one, maximum and minimum. So the maximum is the actual length plus the absolute error, which is now 18.5 centimeter. And when we want to get the minimum value of the length, it will be the actual length minus the absolute error. So it will be 17.5, okay? In another way, 18 minus 0.5, okay? Then coming to the length again, we have, coming to the width, we have our width as 12, okay? So it is maximum and minimum is what you're gonna get. So 12 plus 0.5 is 12.5, look here, 12.5 centimeter, okay? While this one is 11.5 centimeter. Okay, now what I will do is, I will start with the getting what? Getting the actual perimeter, it will help me. The actual perimeter. So actual perimeter is equal to 2 open the bracket L plus W, which is equal to 2 open the bracket 18 plus 12, yeah? Just understand, 18 plus 18 centimeter, just understand, yeah? Plus 12 centimeter. This will give me 2 into that, yeah? 30 centimeter. Finally, we'll have 60 centimeter as the actual perimeter, okay? Then, let me get also the maximum perimeter, okay? Maximum perimeter. The maximum perimeter will be 2 open the bracket L plus W, which is now B is equal to 2 open the bracket. Our L is what? Our L is this one, the maximum, yeah? That is 18.5 centimeter plus the maximum of the width, which is 12.5 centimeter, okay? This will give me perimeter is equal to 2 over the bracket into that 1 centimeter, which will be 62 centimeter, okay? That is the actual perimeter, sorry, the maximum perimeter. Then, let me also get the minimum perimeter, okay? Minimum perimeter. Minimum perimeter is equal to 2 open the bracket L plus W. But this time, we are going to take these two, okay? The minimum of the length and the minimum of the width, which is now 2 open the bracket 17.5 centimeter plus 11.5 centimeter, okay? Which will give us 17 plus 11 is 28 plus 1, 29, okay? 2 into 29, which will give me 58 centimeter. So now let me get the absolute error. Absolute error in perimeter, okay? Absolute error in perimeter, okay? Absolute error in perimeter is equal to maximum perimeter. Just understand, yeah? Maximum perimeter. Maximum perimeter minus minimum perimeter divided by 2, okay? In this situation, understand, yeah? In this situation, what you're gonna do is our maximum perimeter, don't forget, is this one, which is now 62 centimeter minus the minimum, which is 58, okay? Centimeter. Total divided by 2. So this will give me 4 divided by 2, which is 2 centimeter. So that's the absolute error. But you're told to find the percentage error in its perimeter. We know that percentage error in perimeter is equal to absolute all over actual measurement times 100. So actual is this one, not forget. So it will be 2 out of 60 times 100. So that will give me how much? Get your calculator. Don't forget to have your calculator. So we'll have 200 divided by 60. 200 divided by what? Divided by 60. So this will give me 3.33% as the final answer. Just understand that. As straight as that, okay? Very easy, very well coming, okay? That's how we are going to calculate absolute error in the perimeter of the rectangle. What you're going to do is get the absolute error first of the measurement. Absolute error of this measurement is a half times the least unit of measurement. And remember, our least unit of measurement for both the dimensions are is what? Is 8. Yeah, sorry, is 1. Because we have these are whole numbers. So the absolute error in the length is 1, and that in the width is also 1. So for us to get, I really apologize, the least unit of measurement in these two units is 1. Least unit of measurement, because these are whole numbers. If I want to get the absolute error, I will say a half times least unit of measurement, which will give me in both cases 0.5, okay? So this is my absolute error in the dimension, just understand. Then let me maximize and minimize the dimensions. So taking the length, I'll have 18 maximized or minimized. So 18 maximized is 18 plus the absolute error, which will give you 18.5. Okay, just understand. It is straightforward. While getting the minimum value of the length, it is 18 minus 0.5, which will give you 17.5. Okay, the length, do the length the same, yeah? When you go to the, about the width, yeah? When you go to the width, we have 12. The maximum of this one is 12 plus the absolute error, which is 12.5. Then the minimum of this one is 0.5 less this one, okay? Okay? Less that one, okay? Which is now 11.5. Then if you want to get the actual perimeter, is the normal perimeter of the rectangle, 2 open the bracket, L plus W, 2 open the bracket, L plus W, then that will give you finally 60, okay? 80 plus 12, that times 2. Maximum is the addition of the 2, maximum times 2. That will give you the maximum perimeter for your information. The minimum perimeter is the addition of the 2 minimum times 2 there. Then for you to get the absolute error in the perimeter, you're going to say maximum perimeter minus minimum perimeter divided by 2. Then to get the percentage error in the perimeter, you're going to say absolute over actual times 100, okay? Of which you have learned in our previous videos for information. Let's go and see more examples, yeah? This is the first example, guys. Make sure you have your Access book, your calculator, and at least two pens or three, yeah? So that you go with me until then, okay? I'm sure 100% after the next video, which will be the third video, you will not have a problem with this chapter called approximations and errors, okay? You will not have a problem with it, I'm sure 100%. If you are now with me, guys, okay? Let's go. You say mathematical device, we start. It is very, very easy. Okay, let's go. Let's go and see the next example. Okay? Let's go and see our next example, guys. Okay, let's see our next example. Okay. Let's go to this one. You are told that the previous one was about a rectangle, yeah? Let's go for triangle now. Triangle, yeah? Let's go for triangle. Then you will not have a problem with it, okay? Let's go for this one. Remember this, our example two. So you are told the sides of a triangle were measured. The sides of a triangle were measured. Mentioned, okay, and recorded as recorded as 8 centimeter, 10 centimeter, and 15 centimeter. Full stop. You're told calculate the percentage error. Calculate the percentage error. Calculate the percentage error, okay, in the perimeter, correct to these four places, in the perimeter, correct to these four places, correct to two decimal places, okay. Now this is the triangle, let me sketch, okay, let me sketch, let's say this is our triangle. A, B, C. So we have a, let's say this is 8 centimeter, this is 10 centimeter, and this is 15 centimeter. Okay. Now let me take this one. Okay. Let me take BC. I know my BC is 8. Okay. Then what I know is what's obvious here is the absolute error, which is half times one. Okay. So the maximum of this one will be, just understand, we write maximum and minimum. So the maximum will be 8.5 centimeter. Why? It's a half times one, which is 0.5, yeah? Plus the actual length of BC. And the minimum will be 0.8 minus 0.5, that will give me 7.5 centimeter. Let me go to AC again. I have also AC. AC, we have 10, so 10 AC is equal to what? So 10. So this is the maximum. This is the minimum. So the maximum will be 10.5 centimeter because the absolute error is the same. Okay, just understand. Then the minimum will be 9.5 centimeter. Okay, just understand that. Then let me go to AB again. AB is equal to what? 15. So its maximum will be 15.5 centimeter while its minimum will be 14.5 centimeter, okay? 14.5 centimeter. 14.5 centimeter. So now you are told that calculate the percentage error in the perimeter, okay? Now let me get the actual perimeter, okay? Actual perimeter. Now actual perimeter is equal to you add, that is 10 plus 15 plus 8, which will give me 33 centimeter, okay? Because 15 plus 8 is 23 plus 10, that's 3. So this is the actual perimeter, just understand that. It will help us in getting the percentage error, so don't forget. Then the maximum perimeter, let me get maximum perimeter. The maximum perimeter is equal to we add the three maximums, yeah? 8.5 plus, come here, 10.5 plus 15.5. So, don't forget that this is that 3. 8 plus 10 plus 15 is that 3. Plus 1.5, that is that 4.5 yeah, centimeter. As easy as that. Then, the minimum perimeter, the minimum perimeter is the addition of all the minimums, yeah? That is 7.5 centimeter plus 9.5 plus 14.5. So 7 plus 9, 16 plus 14, 30. So it will be that 1.5, okay? Which is that 1.5 centimeter. Just answer that, okay? Then let me get absolute error, okay? Absolute error in the perimeter, okay? Absolute error in the perimeter. Okay, absolute error in perimeter of the triangle. So the absolute error will be maximum perimeter minus minimum perimeter total divided by 2. In this situation, my maximum is what? That 4.5 minus minimum, that 1.5. Then divided by 2. That 1.5 divided by 2. So this will give me 3 out of 2, which is finally what? 1.5. That is the absolute error in the perimeter. Just answer this. Then the percentage error. The percentage error in perimeter is equal to absolute all over actual times what? Times 100. So that is what? 1.5 divided by actual perimeter, which is 33 times what? Times 100. So this is 150 divided by 33. 150 divided by 33. So that's 4.55%. 4.55%. Why are we saying that? Because you are told that, follow the instruction. You are told, calculate the percentage error in the perimeter correct to these four places, okay? So this will be the final answer for your information, guys. It's very easy and straightforward, okay? Okay. Now, let's go and see what if the area is us, okay? The percentage error in the area is us. So what are we going to do? That is the another question, okay, of which we need to consider. Now, I hope you are digesting this thing, yeah? Just understand. We are summing up all the maximum and all the minimum to get the minimum, the maximum perimeter, and the minimum perimeter respectively. Then remember, we have the actual perimeter, which is the summation of the three dimensions given. Then from there, you can calculate your question based on the fact given. Okay, just understand that. Very, very welcome. I hope you are digesting this one also. Bear witness here, please. Who said approximation and error is hard? It's not hard. Okay, I'll give you three videos. This is the second one. When you learn the third one, hopefully you don't have a problem with this thing, okay? Let's go, guys. Let's go and see the third example again. Afternoon will ever be there until time tells him to go. To help you guys and ever help. If you have a problem with mathematics, please leave your comment in our comment box, okay? Don't forget, we are heading to vector, okay? KCSE equations of vector, probability. Don't forget all those things, okay? Formula and variations, we'll conquer them. Don't forget, okay? You will not have a problem with that, I'm sure 100%. Inshallah, God willing, you will not have problem with that. Okay, let's go. Let's see also this example. Let's see this one. Let's see this one, guys. You're told, the radius of a spherical ball. The radius of a spherical ball. The radius of a spherical ball is measured as seven centimeter. Okay, correct to the nearest centimeter. Correct to the nearest centimeter. Okay, correct to the nearest centimeter. Correct to the nearest centimeter. Correct to the nearest centimeter for information. Then yatıyorlar. Full stop ya. This full stop. Correct to the nearest centimeter then full stop. Okay. After that, yatıyorlar. Determine to two decimal places. Determine to two decimal places. Two decimal places. Determine to two decimal places. The percentage error in calculating the surface area of the pole. The percentage error in calculating. You're told the area, the surface area. Look at that. The surface area of the pole. The surface area of the pole. Full stop. But you must have the concept of what? The concept and the formula of getting the surface area of a sphere. That is from two concepts. It's there in our YouTube. We said that surface area of a sphere is gotten as 4 by r squared. Don't forget. Okay? Solution. So let me get first. I know that SA of a sphere, surface area of a sphere, is equal to, well, this spherical pole, the radius of a spherical pole. Okay? You're told the radius of a spherical pole, don't forget here we have pole, yeah? So is area, the surface area of a sphere is gotten as 4 pi r squared. So that's the area of 4 cycles, don't forget. We have learned the area of the surface area of a sphere, the surface area of a sphere, everything in form 2, don't forget, it's there in our YouTube channel. List has to make sure you grab this. So now let me get the radius. I have my radius as 7 centimeters. Okay? Then I will maximize and minimize this one. I know still the least unit of measurement is 1. To get the absolute error, I will say I have to this one, which is 0.5. So I will maximize this radius by adding the absolute error. Okay. Now let me write maximum here, which is 7.5 centimeters, and the minimum of this one will be, don't forget, 6.5 centimeters. When we are maximizing a dimension, we are adding the absolute error to that dimension. And we'll be the reverse when we are minimizing, don't forget. So now let me get the maximum surface area. Okay, maximum SA, surface area. This is what I'm going to say, 4 by r squared, which is 4 times. So you're told to take by as, you're not told to take by, okay, in this equation. So what you're going to do is, even you can take what, 12, so yeah, 4 by r squared, okay, 4 by r squared. So our r is 7.5 centimeter times 7.5 centimeter. So here, what you're gonna do is, it is 56.25, which is 77.5 squared times 88, okay, divided by 7, okay, divided by 7. So that's 707.14 centimeter squared. So that is the maximum surface area. Now let me get the minimum surface area. Minimum SA is equal to 4 pi r squared, don't forget. 4 pi r squared. So in this situation, SA therefore is equal to 4 times by times r squared, which is 6.5, times what? 6.5. That is 42.25, which is 6.5 squared, times 88, okay, then divided by 7, it will give you how much? 501.14, okay, 14 centimeter squared, okay, just understand. So, what will happen is, see, I can get also the actual, because I was told, determine to two decimal places the percentage in error in the in calculating the percentage error, don't forget the percentage error in calculating the surface area of the ball. So now let me also get actual surface area SL. That is 4 pi r squared also, but in this situation SL will be 4 times by times r, which is 7 centimeter times another 7 centimeter. Okay, that's all this thing. I hope that is 88 times 7, just understand that. 88 times 7 to give me, okay, 616. SL therefore is equal to 616 centimeters squared. Now let me get absolute error in surface area. Absolute error in service area. So that will be maximum service area minus minimum divided by 2 again. So my maximum is what? My maximum is 707.14 minus 501.14 divided by 2. So 707.14 minus 5.1.14 to give you the 176, yeah, 176 divided by 2. So that will give me 88. So that is absolute error in service area. What about the percentage error? You're going to say the percentage error in service area, percentage error in SA, service area, is equal to absolute, okay, all over actual. All over actual term is 100. So in this situation, my absolute is 88. All over actual, which is 616, it's here, 616 times what? Times 100. So it will be 88 divided by 616. That is times 100. That is what? 0.142 86 times 100, okay? Times 100. So that will give me 14.1. You are told again not to go to this one place, yeah? Not to get that will be 14.29, yeah? 14.29%. Final answer for your information. What's the idea? There's nothing hard, guys. Okay? I'm still there to help you, don't forget. Okay? And this time around, I'm sure for reading, at the end of 2 months, I'll be done with the high school concept of mathematics, okay? Then I'll go and cover chemistry of high school, okay? For your information, because you cannot create mess up here. Make sure you go with me, chapter by chapter, okay? The concept you have left with Form 1 and Form 2, don't worry about that. The moment I finish, I must complete the concept of Form 3 and Form 4 is when I'll come back and also grab those ones and also channel towards your brain, okay? Just understand, guys. Until next time, I wish you the best day ever. Make sure you subscribe this academic YouTube channel and share with this with your friend and family members for information, guys. Until next time, cheers.